So let's do the infinity spread. That's the divine feminine, divine masculine, with the twin flame union in the middle. So I'll try to do it fairly quickly. Whoa. Okay, so that is shuffled. Get my cards ready. So that'll be night. Whoa, what is going on with these cards? 1 minute. Sorry about that. I take it to be like just a lot of energy wants to come forth. And the cards start jumping around like that. All right, so that will do for me. Get this one more. Good. All right. So how he views his love and relationship. Three of Pentacles. So recognition and reward. He feels successful. He feels like he's been placed on a pedestal. He feels accomplished when he thinks of you. He feels the light shining down on him, like he's illuminated. He feels grounded in the 3D world. He feels like he's laid a foundation. He's successful. He's seeing abundance and rewards as a result of this foundation. He just feels proud of himself. Look at him standing there. Everyone's cheering for him, recognizing him for his accomplishments. So you make him feel this way. So I'm going to pull three cards for that. Nice. The Ace of Pentacles. This is that brand new beginning in the 3D world. He thinks about offering you this key, this new start. And it's a result of this foundation that he's laid, this work that he's done in the past. And he wants a new beginning. So this is the seed being planted. Okay, nice. Oh my God. The twin flame union card. This is a lover's card. He wants to be with you. He loves you. He wants to offer this new beginning. He feels illuminated. And again, with the Three of Pentacles, having that start in the 3D world is really important to him. And feeling that accomplishment, like he's moving forward, like he's, clearly, obviously, it's the twin flame connection. All right, so how you view the love and relationship, oh my God, Ace of Cups, love begins, very strong energies coming from your reading, very beautiful energies. So this means that you've healed your heart, you've let go of the past, you've forgiven people and yourself, and now you are ready to open up your heart and receive. You are the channel of love. Look at you, the two of you coming together in union. That is so beautiful. Okay, so Seven of Wands, obstacles and challenges. It is speaking your truth, expressing, you know, your core values and beliefs. But it's almost like you're blaring with this speaker, you know, at this union, saying, this is my truth. Ten of Pentacles again. You keep getting this card. That is that abundance, that completion, that arrival. It's that final resting place. This is abundance in the 3D world, that state of retirement. But then we have this, you know, new beginning in love. You feel this newness. You're speaking your truth about it. You're feeling empowered. You're not backing down. You're not giving up or surrendering. And this is what you want, that vision, that happy ending. Oh my god. And also, this is a 1, this 10 reduces to a 1, and then 11. Oh my god, I'm freaking out. I'm so freaking out right now. This is so awesome. I'm almost scared to pull more cards because this is too beautiful. You see this as the true 11-11 twin flame connection. There's no doubt about it. And guess what? The universe just confirmed that for you. You both got a reflection of that energy. Wow. Okay, so what you're resisting. The Three of Swords, heartbreak, break and loss. So he is afraid of having his heart broken. And he doesn't want to experience that loss, that pain again. Two of Cups. Four of Cups. And the High Priest, Hierophant. So this is his resisting position. So he is resisting this spiritual union, the Two of Cups, love, coming together. And he feels this sense of stagnation, this non-movement, this it's almost like he's not taking this cup of love, because it's in his resisting position, and he's not taking this cup of love offered to from the universe because he doesn't want his heart broken. So there's this sense of stagnation. It's not moving forward. He's longing, wanting. And then he's resisting stepping into his knowing. This is the High Priest. He's resisting using his inner knowing to guide him. That's interesting. Okay, so your resisting position, balance, this is the Justice card. So for some reason you're resisting that. This is karma coming back to you in a good way. The Tower, Seven of Cups, and Seven of Swords. Wow, 2 sevens and an 8. So that's 11. The Justice card is 11. So balance, this is what you're resisting, okay? So you're resisting balance, finding a balance within. And the reason why you are unbalanced is because a tower must come down. Something major needs to be released. And it's a sudden change. It's the faulty foundation coming down, and so that a new strong one can be replaced by it. So the Seven of Cups is not seeing your way clearly. It's having too many options available to you, and you don't know which one to choose. But it is also about not knowing if something is real, if it's just an illusion. And then we got the Seven of Swords, and this talks about somebody being deceitful, you know, not speaking their truth, sneaking away in the middle of the night and not facing people. It's about taking things from people, not being honest, dishonesty. So you feel imbalanced because there's this energy here that is surrounding you. It's in your knowing, and it's preventing you from being your true, high, authentic self. So the Balance card is being in that spiritual place where you have a balance between your emotions, your thoughts, the physical world, and your spiritual world. So yeah, there's emotions, thoughts, and fears, and false attachments that need to be taken care of for you to find, to feel completely balanced. Okay, so the message from his higher self, nice. Nice, the divine masculine, the male twin flame. So spirit is calling out to him to step into his power. Death card, transformation. The Ten of Swords. Wow. And the Queen of Pentacles. Wow, this is strong energy here. So there's a cutting energy here. Something needs to be released. Yeah, it's... one moment. Sorry about that. Okay, so... Something needs to die in order for something to be reborn. So it's... letting go of old identities and attachments, just cutting them away. The Ten of Swords talks about the dark night of the soul. It is being stabbed in the back and left for dead. But this is a completion of feeling this way. But these are scissors. It's cutting something away. And this also speaks of cutting something away. Okay, and then we have the Queen of Pentacles. So... either this is an earth sign or it represents the feminine in the 3D world. So it's like his higher self is telling him to step into his power and cut away this negativity and move towards that 3D beginning that he's been working towards that he sees in his future. That offer that, whoa, the key, that Ace of Pentacles to you in the 3D world. Let me just pause that and grab that card. Okay, yeah, so here, there's that, he's holding out his hand, he wants to make that offer to the Queen in the 3D. Pentacles are about the material world, physical. The 3D, that which you can touch. Okay, so your message... oh, man, let me just shuffle this real quick here. Okay, message from your higher self. Temperance, integration, ultimate union, coming together of dualities. It's the... S in the yin and yang. So it's it also talks about balance and having patience, planting the seed and then watching it grow. So yeah, again, balance is a strong theme on your side of the reading. So your higher self is telling you to you use self-control, courage, determination, love, compassion to deal with things in your surroundings, situations, you know, making decisions. Let me just shuffle that. Eight of Swords, Ace of Cups, and Ten of Cups. Another 11. Oh my God. So the Ace is that you got that in how you view the relationship. The Ten of Cups is that happy ending, emotional fulfillment, bliss. So these reduce into the 10 reduces to 1, so 11. Wow, that's amazing. And then, but then we got this 8 of Swords, this prison of the mind. You feel locked out of this love, this new beginning, and this happy ending. So spirit is telling you to find balance, find peace and harmony within yourself, and have patience. It's coming. This is coming. So have patience. I know you feel imprisoned, but it's an illusion. It's self-imposed prison of the mind. So take the blindfold off. Let the ropes fall and find that peace within. Okay, his recent past, the magician, the master manifester. So recently he has activated his crown chakra. And that's why this divine masculine is coming in so strong, as well as this kind of illumination here. So it's almost like, you know, he's figured out that he makes his own reality. You know, but then there's this loss here. But his subconscious is telling him to finally cut that away, let go of that heartbreak, you know, that fear. Okay, so that's a one. Nice, a 10. I'm saying nice because it's a 10, which reduces to a 1, so there's an 11. Okay, so this is a 10 of wands. The magician again, another 1. And the strength card. Wow, powerful cards. Magician, he has all the tools available to him to make whatever he desires a reality. The 10 of wands is the feeling of being exhausted. You can't go on. You don't want to, you know, you're taking on too many burdens. You're exhausted. You don't want that alarm clock to ring. So there's a sense that he's done. But spirit is telling him, you know, find the courage and strength within yourself in order to push ahead that one final time. So this is coming up in his recent past. So this is telling me that he's really connecting with the collective. And it's a result of something that happened causing him to give up and walk away from something. Or, you know, find that strength within to end something. 10 is completion. And then the magician is the first card in the major arcana. Well, not the first card, you know, the fool card is obviously the first one, but this is number 1. So this is, you know, making things a reality. It's taking that leap of faith, and then now you want to manifest your reality the way that you want it. But he had to find strength and courage in order to do that. Okay, so in your recent past position, the 4 of cups, disconnect and boredom. So he got this in what he's resisting position. So yeah, there's that sense of somebody turning their back, not accepting that love. And who is not accepting that love? Well, it's him. He's resisting it. He's forcibly turning his back on this 2 of cups. Because he doesn't want his heart broken. So that you felt that energy in the recent past. Hangman, you surrendered, you let go, you released attachment, and you went within to heal yourself and to gain enlightenment, see things from a different perspective. But it also represents, you know, like the significant inner change. So you surrendered, you let go of this energy, that, you know, somebody is not accepting that cup of love. Okay, so the 5 of Pentacles, that talks about being left out in the cold, financial hardship, but it also talks about shooting yourself in the foot in order to get out of a situation. And the Page of Pentacles. So this is all about making plans for the future in the 3D world. So it's working really hard at something, studying, gaining knowledge. So it's like you use this time, this retreat, this pause, in order to heal yourself within, gain inner wisdom and knowledge, and start planning again for the future. So this is your past position. His present position. Nice. Oh my God, this is such an awesome reading. The Ace of Pentacles, again, the key, the seed being planted. So yeah, it's he's thinking of his future currently. He wants that new beginning. And he got the Magician twice. All right, so Five of Cups. The Sun card, awesome. And the Knight of Cups. Wow. Wow. Okay, so the Five of I already explained the Ace of Pentacles. That's a new beginning. See how the two hands are coming together to make that, nurture that seed so it'll grow. And that's what the Temperance card is about. It's about nurturing it. Okay, so that's the major energy. So then we got the Five of Cups here. This is about heartbreak, loss. It's emotional loss. It's when you're attached to something, then that's when you feel pain, loss. So there's a sense that he's holding on to some kind of memories or a loss that is preventing him from moving forward, and it's showing up in his resisting position. That's what he needs to release. It's what his higher self is telling him to cut away. And, you know, it looks like it's, you know, something really painful that he has to go through. But look what he sees on the other side of that. He sees the Sun. This is the best card in the Major Arcana. It is peace, harmony, bliss, returning to innocence. It is a brand new start. It is an optimistic outlook on the future, and he wants that start. He is the Sun. He is the Sun shining down, the center of the Sun. And then we got the Knight of Cups. That's offering your love. The gesture of love. It's poetic, romantic. It is new beginning of love. So it's him wanting to offer you his love, seeing that optimistic future and that new beginning. But there's this heartbreak here, this fear of having his heart broken again. Okay, so for your present position, oh my God. Oh my God. You should share this reading. You know, it is just incredible. It really is. This blows my mind. Okay, so Two of Cups, spiritual union. Five of Wands, obstacles and challenges. Making your light shine. Page of Wands, the fuel to the fire, that communication. It's that movement forward, that inspiration. It's communication of that which you desire makes you come alive. And then the Six of Swords. So there's this energy of the spiritual union not being able to move forward because there's an obstacle that has to do with communication. And then we have this movement away to calmer waters. So, and this talks about moving away from negative people, negative energy, but it's finally being ready to move away from something. So, yeah, there's this obstacle, this challenge, this release in order for that to happen. It's like you're coming in as this beautiful energy, this Page of Wands, but there's this blockage Okay, so for his future position, conflict and defeat, five of swords. So where is that? Oh, I guess he didn't get it. Okay. So yeah, there's that sense of him walking away from negative energy. It's not engaging in fight. And he's walking towards the candle, towards the light. He's going within. Okay. The five of swords. That's what I was looking for. So you got two fives of swords here. So yeah, there's this definite walking away from negativity times two. Two of pentacles. And nice. Oh. The divine masculine twin flame. That's it. He steps into his power. But it requires him to find a balance, inner balance in this nastiness here. Your future, nice. Eight of Wands. These are freaking amazing cards. Oh my God, beautiful. Eight of Wands, communication. Energy coming in suddenly, out of nowhere, out of the blue. It is your hopes and dreams realized. It's shooting for the stars. It's your highest dreams and goals realized. But also it could have to do with communication. Nine of Wands. The Queen of Wands. And the Fool card. So there's this sense of being the wounded warrior. You're exhausted. You want to give up, walk away. You have battle scars, but you're ready to fight. Keep on going. And then we have the Queen of Wands, who could represent a fire sign, but it's more his object of desire is the way I see her. She's charismatic, beautiful, the center of attention. He is what he desires. And then we have the Fool card, which is a brand new beginning. It's taking that leap of faith. All right, so the message from the universe for him. Temptation, the Devil card. It is releasing something. Nice, the Nine of Pentacles. It is being chained to something in the 3D world. It's placing too much importance on material pleasures, or it could be an addiction. So then the Nine of Pentacles is harvest. It is ripeness. It is abundance, prosperity. It's like finally arriving at this place where you feel financially independent and strong in the 3D world and being able to relax and enjoy your life. So the message from the higher from the universe is the Devil. Okay, communication. Eight of Wands again. It is going after your dreams and having them come to you. So that's this energy coming towards him. It's abundance. It's completion. And then judgment. So major awakening. He will have a grand awakening, which will manifest this abundance, communication. But it has to, this chain has to be released. And that's what's happening right now. So this could also represent synchronicities, you know, the universe speaking to him, guiding him. Okay, and message from the universe for you. New beginnings, Fool card. Take that leap of faith. Four of Swords. The Page of Swords, communication. And the King of Cups. So Spirit is saying that there's still something that needs to be released. You still need to retreat to heal yourself, rejuvenate yourself, in order to lay a solid foundation for the future. But Spirit is saying that that new beginning is near, and it will come in the form of clear communication, speaking your truth, and it's about, it's from going to be from the King of Love, pure love, the King of Cups. These emotions, it's deep felt emotional communication. So this reading is getting to be pretty long, so I'm just going to do the divine partnership reading. So we'll leave it at the masculine feminine energies, and then I'll pull two cards with a message from the universe. So this is like an extended divine partnership reading, because normally I don't pull three cards each. Okay, so for his energy that is surrounding him, Seven of Swords again. So that's, you got that in your resisting position. So that energy is coming from you, his surrounding energy. Devil card. So maybe it isn't you. Ah, okay. Knight of Wands and the Ace of Swords. Wow, good for you. So deception and envy. There's that sense of being deceived, not having all the information. You feel like, you know, somebody's not telling the truth. It also represents sudden change. But then we got the Devil card again. It's right beside him, or right beside this other card. So this is the message from the universe. It's the Devil card, and then the energy that is surrounding him is the devil, is in his environment, which is causing this sense of, you know, oh, I got to get away from this. And then the Knight of Wands, that's him going towards his goal. It's leaving. It's you know, towards his future, towards his heart's desire, towards his destiny. And the Ace of Swords is cutting away all the bull, and speaking your truth is, you know, cutting away the barriers. So there's that sense that he wants to cut this away in order to free himself, and he's carrying that sword of truth with him as he rides triumphantly into the future towards his goal. Okay, so the energy that's surrounding you, the Four of Pentacles, that could either talk about holding on too hard or too strong to somebody, or somebody's holding on to you, or a sense that someone's being closed off. So you feel like he's being closed off to you. Temperance card, balance. You got that in message from your higher self. Three of Cups, union is coming. This is about two people coming together for love and celebrating union and love. It's true love. So we got two integration cards, one right after the other. Two union cards. Oh my God. The Divine Feminine Twin Flame. So, wow, this overpowers this energy so completely. But this also talks about laying a firm foundation. So maybe there's a sense of withdraw in order to start that, you know, new life in that the 3D world. And so he feels this energy. You feel this energy of not moving forward, or being someone being closed off, but in reality, you are, there's this union energy surrounding you. It's like he's thinking of you as he's building this foundation, turning away from negativity. He's looking at this, and he's longing for it almost. So this is your surrounding energy. So this energy is coming from him. He sees you as the Divine Feminine. He wants to unite with you. So what does he fear? Crown chakra. Justice card. Seven of Pentacles. Two of Wands. So he fears, this is, I know, it is being linked to the collective consciousness, being linked to Source. And this is the Justice card. This is balance. It is karma coming back to you. It is just balance. Then the Seven of Pentacles is waiting for harvest to come back, waiting for that return, waiting for the ships to come in. And then the Two of Wands is expanding the mind, seeing the bigger picture. But it also talks about making a decision that isn't based on fear. So there's a sense of waiting for that return. You did some work, and now you're waiting for that payoff. And this also talks about having patience while you're waiting for that return. So he fears that his dreams might not be manifested, that he might not be able to walk out that door, that harvest will never come, and that justice will never be served. So it's almost like he's connecting to his crown chakra, and almost like he's praying to God or something. Do you know what I mean? Like, he fears that this is not going to happen. All right, and so what do you fear? Victory and success, the Six of Wands. Victory and success again. Another six. Six of Pentacles, being open, sharing. It's, you know, seeing a return, but being at that point where you can share. But it's about being open and sharing. And Page of Cups, expressing your love, communicating your love. You are afraid to communicate your love. You're afraid of being open. You're afraid that this union will never happen. You know, you'll never see that victory. All right, so now I'm going to look at the bottom of the deck. Moving on, Six of Swords again. So this is a shared energy. So where did I see that Six of Swords? Oh yeah, it's your centered energy over there. So that was that thing that, you know, like that negative energy that he's finally ready to move on from. You see him walking from the dark to the light? So that's the energy of the entire reading, is this movement from dark to light. That new beginning. Okay, so I'm going to pull one card each up here to see what you guys are bringing in. So starting with the feminine, Eight of Pentacles. That talks about working towards something in the 3D. And then the Six of Cups. Wow. And there he is on his chariot. Six of Cups. He's moving towards union, reuniting with somebody that he loves, that he holds dearly. It's something that you've been working towards. You're holding that grounded energy that he's moving towards the light, towards his love. Somebody who makes him feel innocent and pure love. And here he is on his chariot, out of his prison, reaching for the sun. Okay, so now I'm going to pull two cards with a message from the universe, from, call it Aaron Reed. Where are they? Okay, so the first card is going to be for you. Magical Map Shifter. So it's looking at the people in your environment and realizing how they're important change agents and seeing things from a different perspective. And for the masculine, details, 43. Interesting. So this is just about, you know, cleaning up those final little details. Okay, so starting with his card. The most powerful patterns are created within the tiniest details. Pay attention. This is a time to be aware of the fine print in all areas of your life. Look at the details and leave the broad strokes for another time. When this card appears in a reading, it's a sign to finesse a project, make small but meaningful gestures, or add a personal touch to your correspondence. Be aware that what you need to know lies in the details. If you're entering into an agreement of any kind, pay attention to them before, not after, when it's too late. Clarity and transparency are key. You can gain great understanding by observing the minute body language, offhand remarks, and fleeting facial expressions that reveal the larger picture. Okay, and you have 52. So this is your card. Spirit orchestrates everyone's destiny. When the magical map shifter card arrives, it comes with a mission to make you aware of the people who come into your life to impact your personal growth. Perhaps you may meet a soulmate whose presence invites you to be the best you that you can be, or someone who leads you out of difficulty into a place of safety or success. Pay attention to those individuals who cross your path today and cause you to reflect on your journey. Be awake and aware, and you'll recognize them for the important change agents they are. Your whole perspective about who you are and why you're here will shift. The magical map shifter always initiates you into a better version of yourself. Wow, that is such a powerful reading. So I hope this helped. Much love to you.